Today we're drinking that Pinot Noir.
No, we're not. Shut up.
We're getting classy with the Pinot Noir.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Welcome back to Let's Get Classy.
Back again.
Yes, it's been a whole week since you've heard our voices. Where the fuck were you, Mitchell?
I was doing life.
Doing life?
Yeah.
What's your excuse?
You gotta grab the bull and just do it.
You were doing farm animals?
By the horns.
You don't want to do them that way. They got sharp teeth. They'll chop your wiener clean off.
What are we playing?
Yeah, this is Mortal Kombat Deception, which I'm super excited about because I fucking love Mortal Kombat. I love it so much. It's my favorite game series ever. Everybody has that one, like, fan base that they really just grab and own, and Mortal Kombat is mine.
Yes.
What's that for you?
I like The Legend of Zelda and the Mario Twins.
See, now I thought you would have said Star Wars.
Star Wars typically doesn't make good video games.
You have a Star Wars tattoo, though.
I do, yeah.
So you wouldn't say that's the franchise that you most...
We're talking general fandom, then,
well,
yes, absolutely.
Anything at all. All right, before we get too far into this, I do want to say, all right, you see Quan Chi's Wall of Skulls right here that he did?
That was a Wall of Skulls.
Yeah,
yes,
you made a Wall of Skulls as a shield. Yeah. He never has that move in any of the games. That's not a move that Quan Chi has, but he does it in this one video, and it's one of the coolest fucking moves that I've ever seen him do. And it is not fair that he never gets that. This really has bothered me since this game came out in 2004.
Very impassioned about this.
I'm impassioned about a lot of Mortal Kombat. Okay. This is all very important to me.
Well, you're going to have to explain the whole premise of this to me.
Well...
Whereas I like Mortal Kombat, keeping up with the lore is just ridiculous.
Yeah, it does have a complicated lore, and made even like doubly complicated by the Mortal Kombat 9, or just Mortal Kombat 2009.
They done killed Raiden.
Well, it sure looks like it, doesn't it? The voiceover says Raiden's defeated. Alright, so you remember Deadly Alliance?
Yeah.
Okay, in Deadly Alliance,
they killed
Shang Tsung,
Luke.
Well, yes, they Shang Tsung and Quan Chi here teamed up, and they killed Liu Kang and tried to take over. This is the end of that storyline where Raiden's the only one that's left. They kill him and then turn to infighting between themselves because there can be only one true leader.
So it's the Highlander.
Yeah, of course. Well, it...
Well, didn't we talk about something else being the Highlander before?
Yeah, you always want to jump straight into the Highlander.
Yeah.
Whenever there can be one of anything, you want to call it the Highlander of that. Maybe you just watched The Highlander way too much when you were younger.
I've seen it a couple times.
See, I never liked The Highlander. I was always way more into Xena.
Well, Xena's hot.
Well, Xena's hot, and she's badass, and she has that little, what do you call it? The circle,
I don't know what it's called, but it's...
I want to say glaive, but I know that's wrong.
It's the Frisbee of Doom.
Yeah, the Frisbee of Doom, exactly.
What the fuck is that?
That is Onaga, the Dragon King.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Quan Chi kills Shang Tsung. Blood comes out of his little ear to indicate that there's been brain damage, and he's definitely dead. And...
Okay.
Now Quan Chi has power over, or wanted to have power over, the undead Dragon King's army. But the Dragon King army only responds to the Dragon King, who is a reptile. Reptile's not in this game, and in a story mode that you would only see if you played the Conquest mode in Deadly Alliance... Reptile came across a old chamber that was housing this special egg, and he defeated the guardian of the egg, who was Blaze. You remember Blaze?
No.
The guy covered in fire?
Okay.
He was a secret character in Deadly Alliance. He defeated Blaze, and when that happened, the egg cracked, and the spirit of the Dragon King left the egg and went into Reptile, and Reptile turned into this giant monster here.
So that's Reptile.
That's Reptile. The now suddenly resurrected for no reason, Raiden and Shang Tsung are helping Quan Chi try to defeat. They were just dead seconds ago.
Yeah.
Yeah. But for no reason at all, they came back to life to help to try and defeat this monster. And Raiden does this giant power blast, which apparently kills everybody and doesn't work.
Yeah, but not the Dragon King.
No, the Dragon King's still fine. And now he has Shinnok's amulet.
Or is that Reptile?
Well, no, it's the Dragon King now. It just took Reptile's form and transformed it. And that's Shijinko, our hero.
Okay.
The man who we'll spend the next 45 minutes with, learning to love.
I'm confused.
Well, should I go back farther? 100,000 years ago, a tournament was established by the Elder Gods. Oh, yeah, this was the Mortal Kombat that had the chess and the Tetris combat.
Yeah, the chess I think I liked a
yeah,
lot.
We used to play the chess a lot back in the day.
Yeah, yeah.
Because we're friends. We've been friends for over 10 years now.
I don't know you.
And, you know, we played this back on the PS2. I still have this on the PS2 in the living room.
Okay.
And I actually have all these games that we do videos of, because that's the rule of emulation. You can't own a ROM of a game unless you actually own a physical copy of it.
Because otherwise, that's piracy.
Exactly. A ROM is simply a backup of something you already have, and that's totally legal. So this game is sitting on the shelf in my living room as we speak.
Loopholes!
Exactly. Now, going back 10,000 years in the Mortal Kombat storyline from where we just were,
all right,
we see young Shijinko here, LARPing with his friends in the park.
You said 10,000 years?
I sure did.
That guy's 10,000 years old?
Well.
Is that Goro?
Yes, it is Goro.
See, I knew it.
Because he had the forearms?
Because he had stupid hair.
He does have the same little, the up ponytail that
yeah,
Goro
he does.
Has, doesn't he? That's good, that's a good attention to detail.
Observation skills, man.
I bet that happened completely by accident, honestly.
I don't think it did.
And this game does have
subtitles. He's got the same belt buckle, too.
What?
He's got the same yin-yang belt buckle that Goro's got.
You remember Goro's belt buckle?
Yes, I do.
Why were you staring at Goro's crotch for so long?
Observation skills.
Oh, well. I guess you wanted to find out if he had two pairs of dicks also. Should have said balls. That would have made more sense.
Two pairs of dicks. He's got four of them.
You don't have a pair of dicks? I thought that's why pants had two leg holes.
Never heard of a pair
of
dicks.
You come out of one, you piss out of the other. This is getting inappropriate.
It's terrible. Just like a bag of dicks.
You've seen that you can mail a bag of dicks to somebody now. That's a thing.
What?
Yeah, there's a company that produces gummy bears that are shaped like dicks. So I guess they're just gummy dicks.
So it's popular on Valentine's
Day.
Well, what
it is you can tell someone
that's
to
topical.
Eat a bag of dicks. Or you could send them a bag of dicks. Stop smacking your lips. It's going to pick up on the record.
I'm sorry.
We're sorry.
It's the peanut gnar.
Well, yes, I guess that takes us into, today we're drinking Woodbridge by Robert Mondavi.
Yeah, that's the fancy shit.
Yeah, it's $12 for a big-ass bottle, and it's 13% alcohol, so it gets a plus one from us.
Woo!
Yeah, that's a Pinot Noir from California in 2015, so it hasn't aged very long.
No.
I don't think you're supposed to age like super cheap wine, yeah. Really. If you can buy it at a Kroger's, then you can just pretty much drink it whenever.
I think that's with any wine I buy, I'm just going to drink it. I'm not going to...
Have you ever thought about just like maybe buying a cheap bottle of wine and burying it somewhere and then maybe coming back to it in 20 years and seeing if it was, you know,
that
just the most amazing thing you've ever drank in your life?
No, never. I thought about buying a good bottle of beer and aging it for a little while because you can age some beers. Terrapin makes a beer I had not too long ago that you can age, but I didn't. I just drank it. But I thought about it for like 5 minutes, and then I just drank beer.
What is it in the Terrapin, like what makes certain types of beers able to age and other types of beers will just go stale or rotten?
This particular one I think was aged in a bourbon barrel anyway initially, and then you could continue to allow it to age and it would develop a more complex like bourbon type flavor.
And you're a beer guy, we've talked about that before.
Yeah.
You like all the...
There's multiple types of beers that you can age. A lot of breweries do it, but you have to have patience, and I don't have that. I just like to drink good beer.
Yeah, I'm kind of that way, too. Sometimes I'll buy something, and I'll say, I'll hold on to this and save it for a rainy day. That bottle of Knob Creek that I had that was $85. I drank the hell out of that almost, you know, as fast as a bottle of Jim Beam for $20, you know?
Yeah, and yeah, it's hard to hold on to good booze.
Well, that's the problem, is that it is so good that you just, you know, it doesn't feel as harsh as it goes down, I guess, when it's that fancy. Mm. Or maybe it's just, you know, that you spent so much money on it, so you really enjoy drinking it. You enjoy the act of it, the pleasure of drinking it. Because you know that you
worked hard for it. It must taste better because it costs more.
Well, exactly. It wouldn't be expensive if it wasn't better. No one just raises prices on garbage.
No, this never happened ever.
So, that's the best thing about Conquest Mode.
It's just punching everybody.
You can punch everybody. No matter who you meet in this game, you can try and punch them. Sometimes they'll block, and sometimes they'll punch you back. Most of the times, they'll fall flat on their ass.
He hit you.
Oh, yeah, he's a guard. He's guarding that gate to the area that they didn't model or animate or create in any way.
Oh, so you can't get past him either way.
You need to go to your training.
Master bo-rai-cho, he's going to puke on you.
He's going to puke everywhere and then teach you how to do it.
Oh, really?
Well, yes and no.
You can do it too?
Well, the story of Conquest Mode, we'll get to it in a little while, but early on in Shijinko's life, this is young Shijinko here.
How is he 10,000 years old? I want to go back to that.
That's what I'm getting to. All right, so early on, he meets this this floating orb creature who is a he tells him, my name is Damashi. I'm a messenger from the Elder Gods, and I'm here to choose you to be our champion. And Damashi gives him the power to absorb the fighting skills of any person that he comes in contact with. So, using that power, he begins to learn. It's kind of back and forth because bo-rai-cho at the same time is also giving you all these little tiny training missions, and you're learning the moves from him. But then you can literally turn into bo-rai-cho and use his moves. And every time you meet a new Mortal Kombat character, you get to, well, every Mortal Kombat character that's featured as a fighter in this game, you can turn into them and learn their moves, and then Shijinko can harness Shijinko has no special attacks of his own. They're all stolen from other people. He has Sub-Zero's Ice Ball. He has Scorpion's Spear. He has bo-rai-cho's,
Puke Breath.
I don't think he has anything from bo-rai-cho, actually.
Okay.
But he does train with him for, like, 15 years.
Okay. Find the hiding boy.
Yes, this is, I think this is the second one we picked up so far. One of many quests that we will never, ever see the end of. This little RPG that they kind of half shoved in here, half really worked hard at, is incredibly detailed in some areas, and then just so haphazardly put together in others. You can get 100 quests in this one little opening town, but there's no way to check what they are.
And there's no bomber's notebook?
No.
That would be the thing to do, is a bomber's notebook.
Well, yeah, anything that kept track of what you were supposed to be doing. Oh, I did find the boy.
Yeah,
I forgot.
You found him.
Well, good for me.
He gave you a mysterious key.
Well, I've played this Conquest Mode a lot.
Okay.
I've probably sunk over 100 hours into just this one mode alone.
What about the dude that ran away from me real quick? Where'd he go?
Oh, he's the big glowing green light in the sky.
Oh, that's him.
Yeah, you can follow him with your compass.
Okay.
He takes you from training area to training area. He's kind of like guiding you along the little tutorial path.
He ran very quickly.
Yeah, and I'm way more interested in talking to people and trying to steal all the money they have hidden in their houses.
They have $50.
No, they have 50 silver coins. There's 6 types of coins.
Oh.
There's red coins, blue coins, silver coins, gold coins, platinum coins, and onyx coins.
Huh.
Yes. Does that seem like too much?
Yeah, it's
it
a lot.
It fucking is.
It's a lot to keep up with.
And for
now, what was that?
That was silver again.
That was silver again.
Or it might have been platinum, actually.
How can you tell the difference?
Oh,
they
look the same. No, I'm wrong. I was thinking of the GoldenEye game, or the James Bond game we were looking at earlier that has platinum rankings. It's emerald is the other
emerald.
Color. The silver and emerald.
I imagine the emeralds are green ones.
Or it might be platinum and emerald. I don't fucking know. There's six of them. It's too many.
Okay.
And all the coins are used to unlock stuff in the crypt.
Yeah.
Like pictures and little tiny cooking with scorpion videos.
No, that's jade, right? Or is that emerald?
I don't fucking know. They're both green.
Yeah. I imagine it would be jade.
It might be jade because...
Because there is a jade in Mortal Kombat.
The female ninja.
What's wrong with him? I guess he's going to tell us now.
He ate bad chemistry.
And he feels very ill. Find some medicine for the sick boy before 8 p.m.
We will not do that.
No?
No. He'll die because I don't care.
What you need to do is have a handy-dandy notebook. Yeah, I did that. And write down all of your quests as you go along so you can keep up with it.
You're talking about like an actual physical notebook
in real life. Yes, like an actual
notebook. Oh, fuck all that, man. This was the future.
Well, then they should tell you what you're supposed to do.
Well.
What's the point of a quest if you don't remember it?
It told you what to do once. You just have to remember it.
No, you need a list of it.
Well.
I guess that's their idea of a replay value.
The thing is that none of those, it's all side quests, really. None of it's main mission. There's nothing you're going to miss by just not knowing what's going on. Because whatever advances the story is always going to have that big, giant green beacon.
Okay, you're just making crypt money.
Yeah, everything that I'm doing here is just like robbing shopkeepers.
Well, you need that crypt money.
Are you saying crypt money? Or crib money?
I'm saying crypt.
Crypt money. Oh, for the crypt.
Ah.
I thought you were making a different type of joke.
No, I'm not talking gang warfare here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's hard to tell. Because this is a very violent game.
And I'm prone to gang activity.
Yeah, well, it's probably because you played violent games like this when you were younger. You know, the Mortal Kombat series was the reason the ESRB rating system was set up in the first place.
Mortal Kombat's responsible for ratings.
Yes. All the controversy over the violence in Mortal Kombat 1 was the reason that there was an entire system put into place to tell parents whether you're... Because before Mortal Kombat... And there were games before Mortal Kombat that were violent. Like, you play old Sierra games and old, like, LucasArts test-based adventures, and there would be these, like, incredibly graphic, violent deaths. You know, you would fall off from a 5-foot drop and your head would explode, and there'd be this terrible pixel art drawing of your brain splattered all over the floor.
But that's okay.
But it wasn't considered violent because it was, you know, it was a point-and-click little movie thing, and it didn't glorify it, you know. It wasn't like, this is the point of the game. That was a punishment for doing something wrong, whereas in Mortal Kombat, the violence was gratuitous, and it felt like it was earned by the player because it was a series of button combinations you put in at the end of it.
And it was awesome.
Well, yeah, I mean, it is just like how everybody remembers where they were when Kennedy was shot. I think everybody remembers where they were when Sub-Zero ripped the Scorpion's spine out of his back for the first time.
I was in a bar in Jacksonville with my father called, like, Calico Jack's or something like that, and it was an arcade box.
Nice.
Yeah.
How old were you in a bar?
I'm way too damn young.
Yeah.
My dad was a stand-up individual.
I was in a laundromat that happened to have arcade machines. It also had one of those old big table arcade machines that had Pac-Man on it. Do you remember those?
Yeah.
And you had to kind of sit down next to it, but also lean over.
Yeah,
and look
down. Yeah, those are real cool.
Yeah,
I want one in my living room. I think that would be awesome
to use as your new coffee table.
Yeah, that would be so cool.
But you already use a record player as your coffee table.
Yeah, but
how many things that are already other things do you want to use as a table?
I like I like retro
tables.
Tables, yeah, they're cool.
See, so I guess instead of getting rid of the coffee table, you can maybe get rid of your dining room table and put the Pac-Man machine
The dining room table stays. That was my grandpa's.
Ah, okay. Well.
That stays with me forever.
What if you just built the Pac-Man game into the dining your grandpa's table?
No, the dining room table stays intact.
Well.
You're not gonna get me on that one. But I can
maybe you're just too attached to physical objects.
Maybe so. I need to
Platinum!
Platinum!
I knew it.
Shit, I don't care if it's white gold platinum.
Samsonite. I was way off.
You can tell that one's different because it's a little bit shinier.
Yeah, the controls on this are a little rough. He jumps like 6 feet if you just tap it to the side.
I can tell you, I think this might be my least favorite part of any Mortal Kombat game I've ever played in my life.
Oh, man, just wait.
This is just terrifyingly boring.
Who does that look like?
Is that Sub-Zero?
No, it's not Sub-Zero. It's just a member of the Lin Kuei.
Okay.
10,000 years before Sub-Zero was born, for some reason dressed in blue. There's no reason for him to be dressed in blue. The Lin Kuei don't dress in blue, just Sub-Zero does, because he has ice powers.
Right.
Later on, they all dress in blue once he takes over, but that's not now. It doesn't matter, but it bothers me.
I'm confused.
About which part? Why is he about him being dressed in blue?
Yeah.
Or about everything that I just said?
Well, all of it, really. This is trying to follow the Mortal Kombat mythos is exhausting.
Well, there's just been so many years of it. I mean, it's been going on since 1991, I believe. I'm sorry.
Get it right.
I messed it up.
You're supposed to be the authority here.
I am the authority.
And...
And did you know that Brandon Lee was originally expected to play Johnny Cage? And then he died.
Why you gotta bring that sad story into this?
And then he died. And so then it was that other guy.
Because of the curse.
The curse?
Yeah.
What curse?
The Lee curse. The Lee family curse.
What's the Lee family curse? I never really liked The Crow, so I didn't really get into a lot of this.
Bruce Lee had a curse on him that went into the rest of his family, and Brandon Lee died because somebody put a real bullet in a fake gun.
Right.
And then he got shot filming.
And was that ever proven to be on purpose, or was it always considered to be an accident?
I think they always considered it to be an accident, but it was the curse, man. It was the curse. Conspiracy theories.
Who put a curse on them? Was it like some witch somewhere, or did he not carry a woman up a mountain for the 60th time?
Oh man, I don't know. I shouldn't talk about things I don't know about. But
I made a holes joke. Did you get it?
No.
Did you get my holes joke?
No, I don't.
A joke about holes.
I don't know. I don't know holes.
You never read the book Holes?
No.
Never saw the movie with old Shia LaBeouf before he got weird?
No, never.
Well, you should, because you're missing out.
Okay.
It's a good story.
I'll look into it.
I stole the coin from this guy's auction. Nobody seems to care. He says he found it on a quest and it has mystic powers.
And fuck it, it's mine!
Yep, then let's just run out to the street and punch a bunch of people again. Oh, there's that sleeping boy.
Oh, you found him.
Yeah. We're doing some quests. We're not just sticking around. I mean, it's been like 6 days since I got the quest from the guy, because I meditated for a while, and when you meditate, time speeds up really fast, but...
I was just taking a nap. Sapphire coins.
See, what's really cool about this game is that... All right.
Tell me.
There... You see, not right now, but up in the corner of the screen, there's that Monday, and it has the date and the time on it.
Yeah.
There are secrets that are hidden in this game that only show up for, like, an hour on a certain day.
Okay.
And you have to be in the right spot at the right time for just, like, that little tiny window to see it. Otherwise, it'll just disappear, and the whole other 6 days and 23 hours of the cycle, there will be nothing there.
Yeah, there's a way better game that does that same kind of thing.
You're talking about Majora's Mask again. Oh,
yes, I am.
Well, maybe that's why I enjoy this game so much, is because it does give me, like, underlying remnants of Majora's Mask.
I could see that.
I do like the idea of there is a time limit, but also it repeats itself, so if you mess up, you can try again.
Okay.
I don't like a game that has a time limit that you can't come back from. Like, Dead Rising? I love the Dead Rising series, but the first three Dead Rising games comes with this 3 or 4 or 7 day time limit where you have to solve the entire story mode before it's over or you fail. And it but even though it has that, it also has a lot of side quests and little things to do and just fun stuff to dick around with. But you always feel pressured to not do that because there's this time limit bearing down on you.
I've actually never played that one either. Well, I've played some of it, but I never got into any real substance with it. I've been thinking about buying the old remaster.
The Dead Rising... Which remaster?
They got a...
You have a PS4. How can you play Dead Rising?
Because they got
Capcom they is got a bunch of pieces of shit that don't care about their exclusive titles after about a year.
They got a trilogy remaster jumbo pack. It's got 1, 2, and... Then there's like 2.5 or 1.5 or something like that.
I still think 1 was my favorite, but only because I played it the most, because it came out first.
Okay.
3 was a lot of fun. I had 3 right when I got my Xbox One, and I played the hell out of it. I probably nearly 100% completed that game.
Which one is 3? Is that the one with the...
You're the mechanic. And it's real pretty.
I don't think that one...
You can drive cars around and mod cars.
That one's not on PlayStation.
Probably not, because it was an Xbox One launch title.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Jesus Christ.
I'm sorry I said.
Inappropriate.
It's not really. I can't control my nostrils. That's uncalled for. And we're still walking around this damn town.
Well, yeah, man. We gotta rob all the houses.
Oh, man. I'm not done with that. There will be more sneezes ahead.
This is one of the weirder quests. This woman says there's a man who looks through her window every night at 2 a.m. and you're an upstanding citizen, a member of society, so you're like, all right.
I'll take care of it.
I'll take care of that.
She's got a peeping Tom?
She does. And
somebody just really wants to see them boobies.
It really seems like she wants the peeping Tom. She tells you she doesn't. And a lot of these quests are very tonally strange. There's something that comes up later, and I don't want to bring it up yet, because I do want it to be a surprise when it happens.
Oh, but it happens.
But, so there he is.
Oh. That's a big fella. You might not want to mess with him.
And he says, the woman in this house undresses in front of this window.
Oh.
And he thinks it's for him.
So I was right. He did just want to see
him. Well, fuck him. I want his money. Because we all know Peep and Toms are rich as hell.
Now you're going to go inside when she's naked.
But she's not. She hasn't undressed at all. What? What? And so let's watch.
So you're waiting.
Lion bitch.
No, come on. Don't be bitter. Yeah, she wasn't there for you.
I love this weird area of Mortal Kombat's history, because it's such a middle child of a gaming series. You know, you have the early games, which are the young, fun, energetic, punchy you know, just ridiculous off the wall. It's like a bunch of kids running around. And then there's Mortal Kombat 4, which starts off the weirdness.
Okay.
And then it goes into Deadly Alliance, and then this, and then capping it off with Armageddon, which has every character that had ever been invented up until that point just fighting on a mountain. That was the entire plot of Armageddon, is everybody who's ever been here gets together and let's put them all on a big pyramid, and that's the game. That's the story.
At what point did Boone start doing it himself?
John Tobias left after Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3.
So about Mortal Kombat 4.
Around Mortal
Kombat
4,
that's when shit got weird.
Well, yeah, it is. I love Ed Boon. I do. As a person.
As a person.
As a businessman, I think he makes a lot of off decisions.
Okay.
And that kind of brings us into a topic I wanted to cover, and that is Injustice 2.
Injustice 2.
Now, I played Injustice. I know you owned Injustice. I played it at
your
house for
a little
while,
yeah,
when it came out.
On the Wii U,
last week, Black Canary was announced, and this week was Swamp Thing.
Swamp Thing?
Yeah, Swamp Thing's in it now.
Is Swamp Thing a DC character?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it would have to be, right?
Well, I imagine, but shows my comic book knowledge. I have to ask the question.
Well, here's my problem.
Okay.
There's Injustice, the base game.
Yes.
Then there's Injustice, what they call the Digital Deluxe Edition, which is the base game with three extra characters.
Okay.
Then they have Injustice Gold Edition, which is the base game with nine extra characters. And my issue is that
how many extra characters are there?
On fucking release.
Yes.
There is already nine extra characters that you have to pay $30 extra.
That's ridiculous.
To own is fucking ridiculous. This is from, you know, and we're talking about this, obviously, for people that don't know, because Injustice is made by NetherRealm Studios, which was formerly Midway, which is the makers of this game, and all of the other Mortal Kombat games, the first Injustice game, and, you know, some other garbage.
Boyard.
The problem is that this is not something that happened in an instant. It wasn't of a sudden Mortal Kombat 9, Mortal Kombat X came out, and they were just like, oh, now we're going to charge people for the same thing again, because Mortal Kombat's been doing this since they started. There was Mortal Kombat 1, there was Mortal Kombat 2, then there was Mortal Kombat 3.
Then there was Ultimate
Mortal Kombat 3 that had everybody so far. And then what came after that? Mortal Kombat Trilogy.
Yeah.
That had the two characters that hadn't been included in Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3.
Well, you need that one.
And then there was Mortal Kombat 4. And then what was there?
Didn't it go straight to Deadly Alliance
No.
after that?
No. After Mortal Kombat 4, and we're skipping over Special Forces and Mythologies because they're not.
Mythologies.
We're skipping over those. And then, after Mortal Kombat 4, the next real Mortal Kombat game was Mortal Kombat Gold, which was like Mortal Kombat 4, except it added a couple extra characters that weren't included in 4, like Cyrax and Sektor and a couple of the old favorites.
It's hard to keep up with.
And they've been re-releasing the same game over and over and over again since they started. And that's nothing new for fighting games, I guess, in general.
But you could
look at the amount of Super Street Fighter 2 Alpha Omega
Turbo Championship Edition.
Exactly. And that's okay.
I think that's Guacamelee, actually.
you played Guacamelee.
Yeah, the Super Turbo Championship Edition. I didn't play much of it. I played it until I got tired of it. And I enjoyed it. And I just stopped. I get tired of games real easy.
What game have you gotten tired of recently?
BioShock.
BioShock.
Yeah.
You never played the original BioShock, not Infinite.
No, I was playing the remaster of the original.
And how far did you get in it?
I got to some point where I was supposed to save the forest from some green gas.
when they were killed, they had set to kill all of the plants in Arcadia.
Yes, that.
Yes, I do remember that part.
And then I had to go and find all these little items.
Yeah,
over and over again.
That was a problem with the first Bioshock that they did kind of fix in Infinite, was there was a lot of tedious stretching out of the plot by via fetch quests.
Yeah.
And it was just find six glowy pieces of whatever machine you're trying to put together.
Yeah.
And that's something they did probably three or four times. And especially when you're getting towards the end of the game and you know it's coming, it just gets really like, oh my god, fucking this again, really?
You see, I find myself...
All right. So here's what I wanted to call back to. Oh, no, this isn't the lady.
Okay.
Never mind. Go ahead.
I finish talking now?
Yeah, sorry.
All right, I find
myself... Ass.
Me? I find myself in a position where I'm able to play all these games now that I've never been able to play in the past because I've always been a Nintendo kid. So now I have a PlayStation 4. And all these remasters are coming out, and it's exciting. I get to play all these games that I was never allowed access to. And then I start to play them, and I get tired of them because I'm not jumping around on platforms.
You just wish it was all still like the Nintendo 64, Donkey Kong 3, or Donkey Kong 64.
I feel like when it comes to the games that I like, the platforming motif is just too ingrained into my head for me to really go into something else.
Okay, well, say besides platforming, what would be your second favorite type of game, like genre?
Puzzle.
Do you mean that in the sense of Tetris, or do you mean that in the sense of like a point-and-click adventure game?
I like point-and-click adventures. I like, I'm playing a game right now, an indie game called...
This lady!
Okay.
Yes, we talked over it, but there was a man who found this woman's lost dog and ate him.
What?
And then he said, oh, well, I can't give you the dog, but I'll give you the rest of the dog's meat. And then he gives you a bunch of dog meat, and you return it to this lady. And she says, oh, well, I guess it's not a total loss. Let's eat it together. And gives you money. That's the tonal... That
so you went punched her for it.
Well, yeah, because what kind of a bitch doesn't care about her dog? That offended me as a dog owner. I'm going to give this poor lady some water. Maybe she won't use it to, like, waterboard somebody.
Or boil her dog.
Yeah. Drown a baby.
Drown a baby. That, yeah. It's getting real dark up in here.
Well, yeah, it's nighttime and it's raining. But that's just absolutely ridiculous to me. And that's the type of... That's the mentality that we're working with in Mortal Kombat. And that's something that you always have to kind of remember, is that this is a game that is made by 40-year-olds that are 12-year-olds.
Well, they, one way or another, they want to shock you. Whether it be in the violence or just the subject matter, Mortal Kombat is built on shock value. That's their number one go-to. That's how they sell their games. And I feel like we got off of the whole DLC way too quickly. We went to something else.
The microtransactions.
Yeah, microtransactions.
But I want to talk about how the weird blood trails are still going down his dead body like snails on a corpse.
Okay.
But we can talk about microtransactions if you want.
Well, I don't
know. What do you have to say? What do you think about this? Would you buy a game? Would you spend $90 to get 9 extra characters for a $60 game?
Absolutely not.
Here's my problem with digital games.
Okay.
I don't think that a game that is sold digitally should be the same price as the physical copy of a game. Because a physical copy of a game involves shipping, involves printing, involves just the entire creation
plastic.
Of... The plastic, the glass, the paper, everything that goes into it. And not only that, but it has to be transported, it has to be handled by employees at a store. There's all these little tiny things along the way that get it from the studio's computer to the shelf at the store. And the $60 price tag for that game helps every single one of those people along the way. But when you have that exact same file, and the person that makes the game can just upload it from their computer to the internet, and me as the purchaser,
consumer,
just buys it and downloads it to his computer, none of that other shit's going on. There should be a $20 price cut, or a $10, whatever, something that would seem fair.
$10 sounds pretty fair, yeah.
Something that, you know, it is easier, but I miss having physical copies of things.
Yeah, I'm the same way with music and albums and things like that. If there's something that I really care about, I want the physical copy. I want to look through the books, and a lot of bands that I still listen to actually include their lyrics, and that's worth owning. If it's something that...
You're talking about, like, the liner notes that are inside of the album. But a lot of bands don't do that
nowadays.
Yeah,
it's a dying art.
And that's something that it's a dying art in video games, too. Video games used to come with these huge booklets of information about the game. And a part of that was because they couldn't fit...
The whole backstory.
Well, yeah, they couldn't fit the member... You know, you couldn't have a giant sequence. I thought there was a secret here. That's why I'm meditating.
Okay.
And it was like, maybe if I'm here at midnight, it'll pop up. Nothing.
Does it just pop up if you're sitting there?
Yeah.
You have to wake up at a certain point.
No, you can be sitting right in front of it or running around. The entire game area that you're in is loaded all the time, so that if, like, it's noon and something happens on the other side of the map at noon, it'll pop up. And because of that, like, again, it kind of fucks with the memory and everything. And they had a lot of really good ideas going into this, and I don't know if it's because they did fighting games for so long they just didn't know how to do it. It's real... What? What do you want? Why are you making that gesture?
Give me a top off, man. Yeah.
Is it that time already?
Yeah.
Alright.
Glug, glug. Good enough. Thank you, sir.
You know, for a cheap wine, it's not bad at all.
No, it's fine. Did we lose track of topic?
No.
We were, I got so preoccupied with the Pinot Noir.
Pinot Noir.
Pinot Noir.
Pinot Noir.
Pinot Noir. That's enough of that. So bo-rai-cho does the sumo now.
Bo-rai-cho, well, everybody in this game has three fighting styles.
Yeah, yeah.
They did that in Deadly Alliance as well, and it got very good reception because John Tobias's game had just come out, which was called, I'm blanking on it. Do you remember? It was a fighting game for...
I did not realize that John Tobias has done anything since Mortal Kombat.
Yeah, he's continued to do things.
Okay, well that...
I forget what it was, but it was the pioneer of the X-ray system. You know how there were X-rays in Mortal Kombat 9?
Oh, really?
But there was a fighting game that John Tobias helped create that came out around the same time as Deadly Alliance that had a system where your arms could break. It was slightly different than the X-rays, where it didn't, like, zoom. It showed the bones, but what it would do was it, like, if your arm broke during the match, it was broken for the rest of the match.
Oh, wow.
And it was unique,
but it wasn't very fun
to play. And it had a very Japanese-y name.
I think I might know, but I don't know the name. But I think I know what you're talking about.
Well, someone in the comments maybe will know.
Yeah. Somebody in the comments, tell us what this game is, please.
But, so every character
that
in
means
this game...
you in Finland, folks.
Or Ireland.
We
know you speak English, even though you can't say it very well.
Well, that's rude.
Well...
Don't, you know, look down on our followers.
Well, I'm Greek, so there's literally 1,000 things they can say about me.
I'm pretty Irish myself.
Ah, well then fuck the Irish altogether.
Oh, I hate you.
Goddamn potato eaters.
You damn Greeks.
Racism.
America.
No.
And on to better things.
Like I was saying, there's three fighting styles. In Deception, or sorry, I keep doing that. In Deadly Alliance, one of the interesting things that they took out of Deception was that you could press R1 while using your weapon style, and you could impale the other person with your weapon.
Yeah,
Blood would constantly spurt out of the person, and they would take damage for the rest of the match.
Yes, yes, yes.
In this game, it removes the impale function, but you still get a third weapon style.
Didn't Mortal Kombat 4 include a weapon style? Was it only two styles in Mortal Kombat 4, or was it three?
Well, everyone had a weapon option, yes, in Mortal Kombat 4. It wasn't so much a style.
Okay.
It was the fact that you could press a combination, and every character had their own. It was just like doing a special move.
You just had to find a way to bring your weapon out.
Yeah, once you brought your weapon out, you could have it, and you could drop it, and somebody else could pick it up.
Okay, all right. Yeah,
Johnny Cage had a gun, Fujin had a crossbow, Raiden had a stick. Raiden had his hammer, Kai had a stick.
Jarek had a sweet sword.
Oh, fuck Jarek. What a terrible character.
Did I actually say Jarek?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Is that who you meant?
Yeah, that's who I meant. I didn't know if I said the name right.
Did you like Jarek?
Yes, I did.
It's over, Jarek. Shinnok is dead. The good guys won. You're coming back with me.
You don't have to...
Mortal Kombat 4 had the worst ending. Like, here's the thing about Mortal Kombat endings, is that every single game, besides Mortal Kombat 4, has had a stock image with text underneath. Sometimes that text was read aloud, sometimes it wasn't. But those were the endings.
Yes.
Mortal Kombat 4 had full animated endings with voice acting. And... as you can see by this Conquest video here, the voice acting in any Mortal Kombat game is fucking horrendous.
It's not good.
It's not the best. They've gotten better with MK9 and MKX, but on the whole, and for the majority, Mortal Kombat just has terrible fucking voice, because it's just the people in the studio. They don't, like, hire out for these things. It's all, you know, famously, there are, the female characters in this game are just... the male actors in motion capture suits, all of the sexy poses and stuff that the women are doing are just the men trying to act like sexy women.
Is that right?
And so that's why it's very, like, off-putting and unnatural.
Okay.
Is because it's just, again, it's man-children acting what they think women are.
That's why she's got bow arms?
Well, I don't know if any of these people were motion captured. I mean, look at them. Very few of these people move in the way that people move.
Okay, I'm just finding...
Do you remember this quest from The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time? You have to race this guy to get the bunny hat.
Oh, yeah. Is that the postman?
Yeah, exactly. He's the postman.
He's real quick.
He is.
But you're quicker. How do you know where to go?
Oh, I just followed him.
Did you win?
There's only one path down the road. I did.
But you can't talk to him.
Like I said, it's really hard to control the walking around movements.
Well, you still got much training to do.
There's so many little tiny things about this where it just feels like they had better ideas than what the end result ended up being. For me, for a long time Mortal Kombat fan, this still was, like, mind-blowing. And even to this day, I get a little bit of glee out of playing this, because we're in Earthrealm right now, and we stay in Earthrealm for the entirety of this video, but...
Oh, we hadn't talked about realms!
No, there's there's five other realms that you visit in this video. Or in this game, and there's the Nether Realm, there's Chaos Realm, there's Order Realm, there's Adenia. Like, it's just fucking ridiculous.
Oh, Jesus. I can't even...
And so, like I was saying earlier, this is Dimashi. He's an emissary for the Elder Gods, like he says, and he gives you a quest. And your quest is to go out and find the 6 Kamidogu.
Kamidogu.
The Kamidogu are ancient relics that will help them to defeat a power that he will not mention.
Why won't he mention it? Because it's the Dragon King.
Who is?
The Kamidogu.
No, he's the Dragon King. The big floaty orb is the Dragon King.
Oh, he's the Dragon King.
Yes, he starts this plan to get you to organize. The real Elder Gods champion is Scorpion. The Elder Gods have tapped Scorpion to try and stop the Dragon King.
But Scorpion's a bad man.
Well, Scorpion's a bad... Scorpion was never a bad guy. Scorpion was angry at Sub-Zero for killing his... him and his family and clan. But then, you know, it turned out that that wasn't him. That was Quan Chi. And Quan Chi had orchestrated the whole thing. You know about that, obviously, don't you?
I suppose I do.
Well, you played Mythologies.
No, I didn't.
You didn't play Mythologies?
No, not at all.
Well, Mythologies is like the start of the whole thing with Quan Chi and Shinnok and the amulet and everything like
that. I played Mortal Kombat 4. I owned it, and that was the first place that I saw Quan Chi.
Yeah, Mythologies came out right before 4 came out, and it kind of introduced Quan Chi and Shinnok and the concept of the amulet and there being, like, rulers of the Netherrealm and stuff. It might have even introduced the Netherrealm. I don't know if the Netherrealm was even a thing before Mortal Kombat 4. I don't remember anyone talking about the Netherrealm and
Shao
MK3.
Shao Kahn from the Netherrealm?
No, they were from Outworld.
Outworld, okay.
That's a whole different place. Outworld used to be Edenia.
Used to be Edenia.
Yes.
When Sindel was queen?
No.
No.
Well... Yes and no, actually. So when Sindel was queen at first, she was married to King Jared. Mm-hmm. King Jared was killed by Quan Chi, and Sindel was brainwashed into thinking that Shao Kahn... Jared was killed by Shao Kahn, and Sindel was brainwashed into thinking that Shao Kahn was her true husband all along.
Okay.
At the end of Mortal Kombat 3, she remembers the truth, and her and Katana work to transform Edenia back into what it used to be. We visit Edenia and Outworld both in Conquest mode.
Is anybody else as confused as I am here? Because this just does not make sense.
Would it help at all if I told you that there was a kids' TV show that helped to flesh out none of this?
A kids' TV show?
Yes. It was called Mortal Kombat Defenders of the Realm. And
Remember Defenders of the Realm.
Yes. What better fodder for a kids' television program than, a death, murder, bloody...
Oh, yeah, it's perfect.
ESRB.
It's perfect.
I mean... The 90s were a strange time.
But I loved it.
But Mortal Kombat came on after Power Rangers.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
That's why I remember it.
Tao Fang, that was the name of the game.
Tobias?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
All right.
But yeah, that was the game that you could go around and... break arms and stuff, and it was kind of a precursor to having, like, different fighting styles. Even though they didn't make games together anymore, they still were friends and did talk to each other. It wasn't like a...
Because it seems like if he was already doing something where they were breaking arms, he just flat out stole it and put it in Mortal Kombat.
Well, I don't know enough about the subject.
Yeah.
I care more about the actual product than the drama that goes on behind the making of the product. But that being said, I sure like Noob Sabat pronounced Noob Sabat and not just Noob. Because since that character has been created, Noob has gone on to mean a different thing in the world.
Yeah. And so they had to take the Sabat out of the Noob after Tobias left?
I don't know if they had to, but they did.
Okay.
And in this game and Deadly Alliance, I can't remember if it was Deadly Alliance and this or just this, but whichever one, Noob Smoke is a character. They drop the Cybot and they just make Noob and Smoke one character, and they only have two fighting styles. One is for one character and one is for the other. And they switch back and forth.
Oh.
And again, that's just Mortal Kombat reusing the same ideas, because that would later come back in Mortal Kombat 9 for the tag team fighting.
Right.
As well as, you know, occasional weapons usage. It's weird how Mortal Kombat, and now we've even come more full circle to Mortal Kombat X, where you can choose one of three fighting versions for each of your characters. You know, that goes all the way back to Deadly Alliance.
Well.
And it's weird how they seem to have, you know, they've had six or seven good ideas, and they will do their damnedest to run them into the ground as much as fucking possible. And it's sad to see from a franchise that I love so much.
I mean, how much innovation can you put into a product that's been going around for as long as Mortal Kombat has?
Well, that's true. I mean, it's been, what, 17 years, 18 years since Mortal Kombat started? You know, that's an entire person who's old enough to go off to war and die now.
Oh.
Well, that's an entire person that could go off and get a tattoo.
Oh, there we go. Yay. That's fun. Upbeat. Tattoos are fun.
This is not a political commentary. See, this guy right here is talking about the Realm of Sado. Realm of Sado was introduced in this game. It's the Realm of Order. It's boring as shit. Probably the worst realm out of all of them.
You gotta stop punching people just for no reason. It's not nice.
You don't think they deserve it?
I don't think that man deserved that, no.
You didn't see the way he was looking at me, man.
I guess I didn't.
He looked at me crossways.
Crossways.
This is still Georgia. We're still very backwards.
Yeah, you're right. He did have that look in his eyeballs.
These are the monks.
Are they going to let you go by? Because there's money way back there.
Violent behavior will not be tolerated here. So what do you think we're going to do?
Punch everybody!
Punch the monks!
Oh.
Well, this guy's kind of snarky.
He doesn't want to fight you. He wants you to challenge somebody else.
Well, isn't that just trying to get somebody else to fight his battles for him?
It sounds like it.
I think a good monk would stand up for the challenge.
Well, punch him. He's already hurt. Get him.
Let's talk to him first. We don't just want to punch somebody out of the blue.
Oh, I thought that's what we were doing.
No, we have to get to know them first.
This is
Wu.
He's a humble monk.
Yeah.
Punch him now! I'm sure we will, right?
I'm not going to give away the ending.
Oh, he's going to get punched. He's going to get punched right in his stupid face.
Think he's going to get punched?
Oh, I think he's going to get punched, and I think he's going to die.
Yeah, you were right. We did it. Fuck you, Wu. In your fucking peaceful monastery, I'm going to steal all your blue money.
And then knock him out of the way when you're like... $300 sapphire coins. 10 jade coins. Perhaps you should hone your skills more, man.
Look, man. These guys are just full of shit. We're leaving them. We're not going back to that monastery.
We never needed that monastery.
We took their money. We got everything we wanted to hear from them.
We're like Steve Miller.
How?
We took the money and ran.
Oh!
I hate Steve Miller, actually.
You hate Steve Miller? I don't want to hear that. Steve Miller's so good.
I'm really disappointed in myself for doing that.
Why do you hate Steve Miller? What did Steve Miller Band ever do to you?
I hate it.
He's had so many good hits.
Are they good? Are they really good, though?
Yes, they're entertaining, and they make me laugh. And despite the grammatically incorrect nature of Take the Money and Run, as it is, I still really enjoy it as a song. But that just could speak to my, like, really innate desire to love any Bonnie and Clyde story.
Okay.
Like, did you ever watch Natural Born Killers with Woody Harrelson?
I've watched it once. That's a really weird movie.
It's fucked up. I'm not gonna lie. It is a fucked up movie. But, yeah, I love it. God, I love it. There's something that speaks to me about people that just go around robbing banks and doing whatever the fuck they want.
I may not have watched it completely sober, ever.
Well, I don't know if you should, honestly. Well, it's not the type of movie to watch sober. It could leave you some weird impressions. I mean, it's the movie that has Rodney Dangerfield as a guy who molests his daughter to the tune of a audience laugh track in a sitcom.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Now it's snowing all of a sudden.
Well, yeah, now we've reached the headquarters.
Because you're at the
Linkwise. Yes, again. Lots of ice themes for no reason. Sub-Zero's whole shtick was supposed to be he was the only Lin Kuei member that had ever had the power to control ice. That's why he was so important to the Lin Kuei.
Right.
And it was very, very strange to have all these. And even stranger, here's a random guy.
What? Random guy?
And
that's Sub-Zero.
Is it Sub-Zero or is it Shredder from the Ninja Turtles?
He does look like Shredder.
He looks a lot like Shredder.
At least he doesn't look like Megatron.
Well, I look like bo-rai-cho, using the power that Dimashi gave us earlier to take on the other combatants.
Oh, this is weird.
Yes. Now you're remembering. And again, I do want to draw your attention to the really, really weird blood splatter that they do in this game. It's like worms of blood that fall down the body. And there's something about it that really, it doesn't gross me out, but it makes me, like, uncomfortable.
Well, they started that in Deadly Alliance, too. Hey, he can do the Impale, can he?
No.
No, not with that weird ice sword?
I'll tell you, that was the ice sword he had in the last game. And he could impale it in the last game.
Okay, that was Deadly Alliance.
Yeah, in this game, there is no impale. Which sucks, because impale was such a fun way to win fights. If you just impale them early on and run around and be like, nope, you're not going to get me. Your health is falling down.
Sub-Zero could do it. Katana could do it with her size.
I think everybody could do it.
No, it wasn't Katana. It was... No, Katana could do it with her fans, and then there's another chick that could do it with her size. It wasn't everybody. It was only a few of them.
And there's this guy right here. He's dressed like the Grandmaster, but he's not the Grandmaster.
No.
But he says, I'm not worthy. Only skilled warriors can join. I just killed one of your skilled warriors.
Yeah,
I just beat the shit out of him.
You didn't do that. Bo-rai-cho did that.
Well, he doesn't know that. I just walked around, beat one of his dudes in front of him, beat the other guy, and he still doesn't think I'm good enough. It's just not fair.
They never think you're good enough. Nobody ever thinks you're good enough. That's the story of life. It's life.
Well, fuck life.
Yeah. Why don't we just kill ourselves?
Nah, I'm not gonna kill my... You know what I'm gonna do? As I told you before...
Punch everybody.
This fucking goddamn bastard... No. I'm going to stay calm. I'm going to stay calm, and I'm going to meditate.
Okay, yeah.
And...
I'm sorry, I got...
I think we should all remain calm.
I got real morbid for just a second. I didn't mean to do that.
Well, I think this is as good a point as any to call it. So, good night, Mitchell.
Good night, Chris.
Good night, everybody. Stay calm and stay classy.
Don't kill yourself.
Or do if you want. I'm not your boss.